I've got an exciting announcement to make. We're starting a brand new series, but we always do. No, this is different. We're starting a brand new way of teaching at the feast. You see, for the longest time, what we do is we group the talks into a particular topic. You know, for example, how to meet Mr. and Miss or Miss Right, or the creed, or hustle, you know, we bunch it up, and then so we give it for a month, usually four talks, sometimes five, sometimes three, but thereabouts. Well, we're starting something exciting and something brand new. We're changing the way we teach God's word at the feast. Why? Ask me why. Next year is the 40th anniversary of the Light of Jesus family. Now that's huge. I mean, I was 14 years old when we started that prayer group in that small garage. And 40 years later, we're here. And you know what? I believe that God is birthing a new generation. Because in the Bible, 40 years is one generation. He is birthing, God is birthing a whole new generation of people who will hunger to follow the Word. We're going to teach the Bible by book and go verse by verse, chapter by chapter, story by story. We're going to do it that way. What's going to happen? We're going to sit at the Master's feet with total humility and allow the text as divinely inspired to speak to our hearts. It is going to be awesome. Now, I know you're going to say, what? Verse by verse, chapter by, isn't that boring? You don't know what you're... Now, listen to me. It can be. But if you have an open heart... In fact, I want you to understand this. We're going to speak to two audiences, always. Always two audiences. Number one, the churched. And number two, the unchurched. Now, I want you to understand that the unchurched, they're the reason why the church exists. We're here to reach out to people who are far from God or far from the church or who are not very spiritual or who feel... These are the people. This is the reason why we have the feast. We're going to continue to speak to them and reach out. We're going to use their language. We're going to meet their needs. We're going to love them. We're going to serve them. But in the same talk, we will also speak to the churched. Because after 40 years, listen to me, there are people in the feast who've been with us for the longest time. And we're going to also speak to them because God wants to deepen their longing and their hunger and their understanding of the word. We're going to give them solid food as well in the same talk. Yes, it can be done. In fact, I'm going to give you the reading from Hebrews chapter 5, verse 12. And it says, there has been enough time for you to be teachers, yet you still need someone to teach you the first lessons of God's message. Instead of eating solid food, you still have to drink milk. Verse 13, anyone who has to drink milk is still a child without any experience in the matter of right and wrong. Verse 14, solid food, on the other hand, is for adults who through the practice are able to distinguish between good and evil. And so as we reach out to the unchurched, we're also going to speak to the churched and we're going to deepen your understanding of the word. Now, you need two things, and this is the attitude I want you to take. Patience and humility. Because what are we doing? We're going to study, the first book that we're going to study is the first book of the New Testament, Matthew, the Gospel of Matthew. And we're going to take about maybe 2 years going through this book. Now, I know, it's like you're raising your eyebrow, and then the other one, and you're saying, what? 2 years? No, Bo. Yes. That's why you're required to do two things. Number one, a lot of patience. And your spiritual life, you need that too. You need to be patient with yourself. because God wants to do a lot of things in your life, but it's going to take a long time. Stop counting in days. Start counting in decades. God is doing something beautiful in your life. And in the same way that you're not going to change overnight, you're not going to learn Matthew overnight as well. We're going to take 2 years. So you need that patience. Here's number two. You need a lot of humility. You need a lot of humility to read a text as though you're reading it for the very first time. Because, you know, many times you listen to the story of the prodigal son, for example. Oh, I've heard it 282 times already. No. Open it and read it and be humble and allow God to speak to you. Three last practical instructions. Number one, you've got to get a readable Bible. Get one, grab one, buy one. I recommend the Good News Translation. Very readable. Let's start there. Catholic edition. And, you know, read it, get it, and hold it, and touch it, and dirty it, and underline it, and circle. Make the text your own. And number two, every day, read Scripture. Where do you start? You can get the Companion, the Didache, the Sabbath, you know. Make that your guide every day. Allow God to speak to you. And the way to do that is to create a pattern. Like every day, you know, it doesn't matter. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, start there. Every single day, attach it to something that you're already doing every day. Breakfast, so let it be before breakfast, after breakfast. You eat lunch every day, right? So how about before lunch, after lunch? You know, find a way to create a pattern when you read the Word. And you can also download our app, and it's all there. Number three, I want you to read the text before the coming talk. So we're going to tell you what text you're going to read. Again, one of the advantages of having a physical Bible is you can make the text your own. I want you now to get ready because we're going to start this journey of longing and really understanding God and His Word for you. Be so very, very blessed.